Friends, today we are going to study microcontroller based embedded system. Learning outcome: at the end of this session, students will be able to analyze microcontroller based embedded systems. You have to pause this video here and you should recall definitions of microprocessor and microcontroller and what is the difference between microprocessor and microcontroller. In embedded system, hardware processor is an important unit. It is called as heart of embedded system. For the embedded system designer, knowledge of basic concepts of microprocessor and microcontroller is must, so that we can use a particular processor or a microcontroller into an embedded system. So generally, a processor will have two important units. First one is control unit and second one is execution unit. Control unit is to be used to fetch instructions from the memory, and execution unit will execute a particular instruction as well as it will perform some another operations related to stack as well as interrupt as well as IO related operations and so on. Execution unit will also consist of ALU, that is arithmetical and logical unit, which can perform arithmetic as well as logical operations. Now we'll see an embedded system processor chip or core can be one of the following. First one is general purpose processor. So general purpose processor is to be designed not considering the application. So it have in general instruction set. So generally microprocessor or embedded processor are the example of general purpose processor. Second one, application specific instruction set processor, that is ASIP. So ASIP is designed, or this type of processor is to be designed by considering the application, or instruction set of ASIP is application specific, and its example are microcontroller, embedded controller, DSP, that is digital signal processing controllers, network processors, IO processors, etc. Third one is single purpose processor or additional processor. So a processor which is to be designed to perform a specific task is called as a single purpose processor. Examples are coprocessor. Coprocessor is like graphic processor and so on. Second option for, or second type for single purpose processor is accelerator. So Java accelerator or some other type of accelerators which are to be called as a single purpose processor, as well as some controllers like DMA controller and peripherals. All these are called or categorized as a controller which are to be used for a particular purpose, that is single purpose. Next, GPP or ASIP cores integrated into either an ASIC or VLSI circuit. So general purpose processor or application specific instruction set processor, or this type of processor, are to be integrated into VLSI chip or ASIC chip. Last one, application specific system processor. So based on the application, a particular processor was to be designed. So that is called as an application specific system processor. So these are embedded system processor chip or core which are to be used in an embedded system. So microprocessor will consist of CPU, that is central processing unit. So that central processing unit is to be used to perform arithmetical, logical operations or for some computation purpose. So generally microprocessor is to be used to perform computation, or the microprocessor will have a CPU as its main unit, as well as it will have some another units like ALU, processors for pipelining, as well as superscalar and so on. So generally microprocessor will consist of CPU, and that CPU is going to fetch the instruction as well as execute the instruction. So while executing the instruction, data from one address of the memory is to be transferred to another address likewise. So such type of operations are to be performed in microprocessor. So there are so many companies which are going to manufacture microprocessors, and examples are Intel, Samsung, Motorola and so on. A famous or basic model which is to be designed or first design microprocessor is 8085 microprocessor. So if we understand the concept of this basic microprocessor, you can understand the concept of higher versions of microprocessor like 80x86, that is the next version of microprocessor, as well as some other companies are also manufacturing the microprocessor, like Motorola has designed 68HC series microprocessors. So generally microprocessor is to be used to perform fast computation, and the microprocessor will have just CPU and other part are present as a part of the chip. So microcontroller is used when a small or part of embedded software has to be located in internal memory, and when on-chip functional units such as interrupt handler, port, timer, ADC, PWM and CAN controller are required. So microcontroller is another important part of embedded system, and microcontroller will have a microcontroller and its memories, that is RAM, ROM memory and some other functional units such as interrupt handler, port, timer, ADC, PWM and all these are on a single chip. So a single VLSI chip will consist of microcontroller and its other peripherals and memories. So microcontroller are to be used for specific application. In embedded system, to design a specific application, we have to use microcontroller. So instead of computation, if we are focusing on the accuracy in the input output or to perform a specific task, we are going to use microcontroller. And type of microcontrollers or microcontrollers which are to be designed by Intel is 8051, that is basic type of microcontroller. And some other microcontrollers are also designed as PIC 18 or PIC 16 series microcontrollers and so on. Now, complex system design and processors. So a complex system designs are to be designed with the help of embedding different microprocessors as well as microcontrollers. Into that, first one is embedding a microprocessor. So as we have seen the different example of microprocessor, that is 8085, 8086, 68SC families and some other type of microprocessor, that is ARM7 or ARM9. So these type of microprocessor are to be embedded in complex system design. Embedding a microcontroller. Similar to the microprocessor, we can embed microcontroller into the system design, and there are many types of microcontrollers as we have seen. 8051 is the basic microcontroller. Similarly, the higher version of microcontrollers as well as PIC microcontroller we can use for system design. Embedding a DSP. So digital signal processing is important part in signal and speech processing. So some DSP processors are also used for system design, and these DSPs are to be used for image, audio, video, HDTV and some other processing purposes. Next, embedding an RISC processor. RISC processor are considered as a faster processor as compared to normal processor. So some special instruction sets are to be designed in RISC processors. So these RISC processors are to be used for faster processing as well as computation. Embedding an ASIP, application specific instruction set processor. So these type of processor are called as a microcontroller or some higher versions of the microcontroller. So these type of controllers are to be used for complex system design. Next, embedding a multiprocessor. So sometimes it will happen that a single processor will not perform a particular task within a deadline. So in that case, it is required to use multiple processors at a time, and the processors are to be synchronized. So in case of image or video processing, a single DSP or single digital signal processing unit will not perform a particular task within a deadline. So 3 to 4 DSPs are to be used or acting in synchronization so that particular task is to be completed within a deadline. So that is embedding a multiprocessor. Embedding an ARM processor. ARM processor are the higher version of the processors which have to be used for a large scale embedded system or higher version of the embedded system. So in such complexity or higher versions of the system design, we are going to use ARM processor for the embedding. Embedding processor or embedding microcontroller. So embedding processor will have a specific ability which will embed those abilities into a single system. So the specific ability or specific application or its importance for embedded processors are where we can use this processor is context switching or low latency time. So in case of low latency time or context switching, that embedded processor is acting its major role. Second one is 32-bit RISC processor, which to be used for higher accuracy and faster computation. And third one is capability or its capability of 32-bit or 62-bit atomic addition as well as multiplication. So for its these capabilities, important capabilities, we are embedding the processors. Similarly, we are using microcontroller, that is embedded microcontrollers, for its a specific ability, and its abilities are microcontroller in a system where it require that microcontroller and its other peripheral like memory, interrupt handler or ports or some DSP processors or some interrupt handlers should be present on a single chip. So in such type of embedded system, we are going to use embedded microcontroller. And second, its capability is again same, context switching or low latency time. While preparing this video, I have used Internet of Things by Raj Kamal. Thank you.